Hey guys, today I'm painting an autumn landscape with trees and very bright colorful leaves with the yellow, orangey and red colors. And most of the time I work wet on wet technique. So first of all I need to wet the back of the paper. It takes about 10 to 15 minutes for paper to absorb all the water. So then I turn it over and then I wet the frontal side of the paper. I'm starting to paint from the background and I'm using a blue colors, very cool colors. So this is lavender, phthalo blue and neutral tint. Make a very transparent mix of it because this part of the painting is at the distance, so everything will look cooler. So then when we painting further, the frontal trees will be brighter with the warm brown and yellow colors. I start to add yellow colors at the front, at the bottom of the painting. Try to paint loose and with a transparent mix, because later on we will add more texture, more brighter and thicker colors. Coming back to the distant trees, I'm mixing a grayish color from the green, blue and red, which is a pyrrhine green, ultramarine and alizarin crimson, plus lavender. I paint without details. I just block in some shapes, some lines, and then smooth with a soft gold hairbrush. You can paint the same gray color between the trees. it's time to add warmer colors. So I add burnt sienna to the gray I have already on the palette. So I start from the very back trees and I paint with a transparent mix. As you come closer to the bigger trees on the front, you can paint thicker and brighter. You can start to paint in some foliage with the burnt sienna. This painting I decided just to splatter the paint on top of the trees because I think this way all the foliage will look more natural. Keep adding different colors to the foliage. Now I'm having a perilling green and burnt sienna mixed together. I splatter on top of it yellow. I have an azo yellow medium, but you can use a cadmium yellow or any yellow you have. As you might already notice that I'm going from the light to the dark. So now I'm going with a darker color, which is alizarin crimson and burnt sienna. I'm painting the stem of the tree. And I'm still keeping it pretty transparent because I will add more details later on. I will paint some leaves on the ground. I'm using yellow, orange, red, green, brown colors for that. And make sure you don't put any leaves and details at the back of the painting. add more color to the closest trees. This large tree at the front will have more texture and more details. At this stage, I need my painting to be dry at the front, but I still will keep the back of the painting wet. Now I'm adding more texture and some drawing to the stem of the tree. I mixed a darker brown with ultramarine blue, a burnt sienna, with some purple and darker brown. I continue to paint the stem of the tree with the brown, and I'm making a different pattern inside, so we have an overall look like a tree is covered by the foliage in some of the areas. try to paint different colors, switch the colors, make a transparent mix or a darker mix, so that will have more interest to the painting. For example, here I mix burnt sienna and purple, which makes a lighter color. And then for a darker, I paint with the purple and Van Dyke brown, so that makes a darker. And now it's time to get some details at the foreground. So I need to paint some separate leaves and kind of leaf shapes on the front, because these trees at the foreground, they are very close to us, so we are able to see some branches and some separate leaves. Thank you. You can paint just with the random brush strokes. It doesn't matter, it has no any detailed leaves inside. So make some pattern and try to switch the colors. You can start from orange, then add some alizarin crimson or burnt sienna or green colors. So the foliage will look different. Also, you can continue to splatter some of the paints at the front of the trees.
Thank you.
have 11 yellow. For highlights, it's a very opaque color, so I'm nearly getting it from the tube, like really thickly, and I haven't kind of very tiny dots and strips all around the foreground. And now I will add some shadows under the leaves, so you can mix some brownish color. I'm using alizarin crimson and purple, that will make a darker mix. Also, you can make some branches or paint some separate leaves with the same color. And my painting is nearly finished. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoy this tutorial.